he has worked a lot of appeal, and the appeal is not rigorous and has a likelihood of success. That substantial loss may result to the applicant unless the stay of execution is granted, that the application has been made without unreasonable delay, and that the applicant has given security for due performance of the decree or order, as may ultimately be binding upon him, that there is serious or imminent threat of execution of the decree or order, and if the application is not granted, the appeal would be rendered nugatory. And then the last one, that refusal to grant the stay would inflict more hardships than it would avoid. The Honorable Principal Judge stated the law and looked at the submission by each counsel to each of the principals I have read. So I will look at one by one and will specifically go to his findings on each of those principles. Concerning the first principle, which is the applicant must show that he wrote a lot of appeal, and the appeal is not rigorous and has a likelihood of success. We looked at this principle under three aspects. The first aspect being the procedural aspects. Here he stated thus, under Order 9, Rule 10, where there is no defense filed, the suit proceeds as if a defense has been filed. It follows, therefore, that even when the defense is struck out, the suit must proceed for form of proof as if a defense exists. Save where some claim is a litigated sum, counsel for the applicant submitted that this was not a litigated sum, while counsel for the respondents argued that this sum was a litigated sum. In view of the fact that there is this contention, it is proof enough that there is an arguable ground of appeal. In view of the fact that the parties had agreed in the joint scheduling memorandum to have an audit to ascertain the amount deducted from the plaintiff's account, vis-à-vis what they received as the prior judge had appointed ICPAU to conduct the audit, which order he vacated, it remains to be determined by the Court of Appeal as whether this was actually a litigated sum that would be awarded without formal proof. The question for the Court of Appeal to tell you will be why agree to an audit if the sum was liquidated. The trial judge enters judgment under Order 9, Rule 6, 8, and 8, 10, and 30, and under Rule 8, the requirement that where judgment is under is entered under Rule 8 of Order 9 of the Civil Procedural Rules. The suit is sent down for assessment of damages which the judge did not he denied the respondent's damages without proof or failure to prove thereof. It is therefore not clear whether the judge entered an interlocutory judgment under Order 9 Rule 6 or Order 9 Rule 8 or both. This coupled with the fact that Order 9 Rule 30, which he referred to, does not exist, are questions for the Court of Appeal to determine. The second aspect he looked at was one of illegality. He stated thus, both counsel strongly submitted on this aspect of illegality as shown above. At common law, the principle of public policy is enshrined in the Rathmark. I will not go into the Rathmark here. Okay, it is enshrined in the Latin magazine, which literally, the Latin magazine, that no court will lend its aid to a man who holds his cause of action on an immoral and an illegal act. In such a case, where a contract is illegal, The court leaves the parties where it finds them. The court will help neither party. The only exception is where a statute is caused in a way that it protects a particular party to the contract, as explained in the case of Kulia versus Sin. The Contract Act 2010 has modified the position of common law. Section 19 of the Contract Act provides as follows. We produce Section 19. That is subsection 2. That an agreement whose object or consideration is unlawful is void, and a suit shall be brought for the recovery of any money paid, causing delivery or compensation for anything then done under the agreement, unless the court is satisfied that the plaintiff was ignorant of the illegality of the consideration of object at the time the plaintiff paid the money for the delivered the thing or to be recovered, only the thing is listed for which compensation is sold. The court is satisfied that the illegal consideration or objects had not been affected at the time the plaintiff became aware of the illegality and repudiated the agreement. The court is satisfied that the consent of the plaintiff to the agreement was induced by fraud, misrepresentation, coercion or undue influence, or the agreement is declared illegal by any written law with the object of protecting a particular class of persons to which the plaintiff is one. In view of the fact that the trial judge issued orders in favor of one party in a transaction found illegal, and he made no mention of the sums the plaintiff's borrowed, it will be an important question of law for the court of appeal to determine as whether the illegality did not apply to the respondents as well, or whether the respondents are one of those protected by the law. The parties were found to have violated. The court will have to determine whether the transaction was illegal in the first place, since this remains contention in the submissions of both parties. The court will have to determine whether the respondents fall under the category of exceptions under Section 19, Subsection 2A of the Contract Act, since the loan agreement shows that the respondents receive independent advice from counsel before signing the agreements. And then the third aspect we looked at is the agency granting. And he said that that's the other question that will be of interest to the Court of Appeal is the question of agency, as whether foreign banks are not trading in Uganda, as whether foreign banks are not trading in Uganda, are required to obtain a license from Bank of Uganda to execute a contract is a good question for the proposition. In a statement issued, which was annexed to the African Statute in Uganda, Bank of Uganda suggests that license was not required in the transaction under dispute, and the Court of Appeal will have to determine whether Bank of Uganda is right or not. That was the first principle, then we got the second principle, that is substantial loss may result to the applicant unless self-execution is granted. Submissions of authorities provided by both parties, and this is what he had to say. My take is that this decision has far-reaching implications on the banking industry, as far as it declares indicated loans illegal. At page 22 of the ruling, the trial judge stated, the fact of this matter shows indicated financial institutions institution business. But there is serious or imminent threat of execution of a decree or order, and if the application is not granted, the appeal will be rendered nugatory. My take is that the nature of these orders made by the prior judge has sent executions. The following orders will be of interest of the other parties for the suit, who shall approve it with or without amendments, or reject it without undue delay. If the draft is approved by the parties, it shall be submitted to the registrar, who, if he or she is satisfied that it is drawn in accordance with the judgment, shall sign and seal the decree accordingly. If all the parties and the registrar do not agree upon the terms of the decree within such a time as the registrar shall fix, shall be settled by the judge who pronounced the judgment, and the parties shall be entitled to pay hand on the terms of the decree if they so desire. Any order, whether in the High Court or Magistrate Court, which is required to be drawn up, shall be prepared and signed in the right manner. Execution, therefore, was a big possibility, hence the risk. The rest of the order will require an application for execution as a condition precedent. Principle number 5, that is that the applicant has given security for due performance of the decree or order as may ultimately be binding upon the honorable for the principal judge have submitted to this left by both counsel. This is what you have to say. I have held before that every application should be handled on its merits and that decision whether or not to order for security for due performance should be according to the circumstances of each particular case. The objective of the legal provisions on security was never intended to fetter the right of appeal. It was intended to ensure that courts do not assist litigants in the execution of decrees through filing excessive and rigorous appeals. In essence, the decision whether or not to order for security and for due performance must be made in consonance with the possibility of the success of the appeal. It was held in the case of the Honorable which he has cited earlier, that the nature of the decision depends on the facts of each case and situations vary from case to case. The applicants are banks with an international presence, and given the amounts that they lend to the respondents, they are liquid enough to meet the obligations under the decree. Should the appellate courts confirm the judgment entered against the respondents by this court, in effect, I shall not order security for due performance. Principle 6.
Mwena mchimanyi ti banafi wa na Uganda balu dekisela giving to ya witu wali wa bankers ni banyi giri zibwa. Is it fair nti abantu wana abagenda mu banka okweola oluna kurote kecha pacho mu banka wala chikute bana Uganda abasinga bagenze mu bankers ni niliola sente necha mkisa mubi. Itintundu chinda mumu nana kuchukuli. Tewali afunia wengkanya kwa mbanga zi. is it in Fenat to live across in Gabana Uganda? Over structures, systems, and policies, is it one of mass? Zinfu, it is so good the stuff in Gabana Uganda for a gain of mass. Cham Samurudi, the Musus and I attend and the lawyer. Nasara wechi tu chino chino vile dagala Uvanyuma loo kusanga Bank ya Diamond Trust Bank Yagi ya sende Ezisuwa mbumu chukumi mwabi Uva kwa akaunti ya Ngasawa wa lukisa ziki yako Wawulanga bazi yako mkuju kuju Mubanga ya miaka kuli Natuwala DTB mbank DTB bank mkoti Kukomasho division Umusangu kwa uigwa Okumali hizi jisuwa mwanaana. Era uluvanyuma koti ya chizula. Tidala mtu kusente za ngebali wazikulaji. Bazi jaku. Ati ngeba menyana mateka. Wamanga koti nila gira. Bakwate sente za ngebali wazikulaji. Bazi Necha naku. Obacha amukisa mubi. Jimukoti mwenyini jitugenda okufuna owenkanya. Ate mulimu. Betwali said judicial officers in Ega because of Ava Guidaban, Dabalu Nigiriza Munna Uganda, Owawasi. A chief Chanaku knew Naya Telachpoof. Principal Judge Muzimu Murava Munna, Twagan Rumu Commercial Court Five Naji Yakuma Taina, the instrument, not even an administrative instrument. Kwa is an administrative officer? Okuja Faiwan. Never feel the commercial court Sawa Munana. Tugenda okutuukayo nga batuka ma file teriyo tugenda okuwulira ekiro ssaawa ngaemu ku social media tegayisizaako order a stopping execution kyatuyisa binene tusooka ne tusirika nuga katwetegereza omusajja ono tulabe bigende lwali fairo agifute akamwenna mukimanyi nti nateekayo n'omusango banawandiika mu judicial service commission ne baloya bange bawandika ne bawandika ne chief justice Ngaba mugamba kubikolwa bino ono principal judge byazakola okuwanda maininga independence of the judiciary ng'omuntu judiciary agitambuliza musajjo nali compromise era nzenki bagamba n'ekibadde wano leero it is conclusive evidence nkinali mbagamba n'ekinawandiika mu judicial service commission kituufu luno olutalo bannayuganda temulutwala ng'olwa hamu luno olutalo luneneko Abasajja bajja wano ne batunyuunyuuta waleeta ssente wano tebaagala fe bannayuganda tuzifune baziyisa kabalaza tebasasula misolo gya gavumenti kati ensonga temugitwalira kungulu nti eri ku amu yekka ensi egaanye okulaakulana lwansonga abantu abajja mu ggwanga lyaffe okukoleramu ba banka zino bajja tunyuunyuuta tebajja tukulaakulanya omusango gwaye guno gugenda kusettinga president tugugenda kukwata economy gujize mikono gya febaki bana Uganda chobola abava ne bagamba ati kati hamba na musanga kusinze ne tuina 5.7 trillion shillings mu economy ezigendo freedom nitubabuza ati musobola okuleta ku balance book ya tax returns ya sente ezo twasobola zikulaga lwansonga batulabanga abawansi they look at us from an inferiority point of view yenga kyannaku kuba bakyatutwalira ddala ng'abaddu ate mu nsi yaffe mu bakola era kyannaku era kikwasa ennyiko okulaba nga tugenda mu kkooti nga zino hamu n'omu defiriyoni 12 ne wadderooya ali saidi ne naye omulaba afaanana nga naye ate nga kumbulutayina mutima guli lwaki gwanga ne tubeera nga tulwanagana ffe kennyini nnyini tyaa muliki bana abagwira bakole ki banyunyute muna Uganda bamubbye ne kkooti ekirabye tebakoze eki tebamu kati ate babano beegasseeko n'abalamuzi ate abalina okutuyamba okulaba nga ba implementinga principles of justice n'ekibaddewo leero sigamba nti olwo basaza obusango buwedde nti amu tebagenda muddiza ssente ze oba ekonomi tegenda kudda eri ffe nga bannayuganda wabula ekibaddewo bano baloopa wammanga oba basaba kkooti wammanga through the principal judge nti agira ayimiriza ekikolwa kya hamu okujja ssente ku akawunti ezamuweebwa okutuusa ng'omusango wano guwaabaaba ku court of appeal bukoze eki buwimbwa principal judge era asazeewo n'agamba nti ekyamu okuexecutinga judgment oba decree awo wa commercial court kigira kiyibirira paka omusango ate ogwawaaba ku ki
kukoto vapi luguhuli mbwa. Na ye, ingeri jetuwe sika kato, nangawe tu gamba for God and my country. Taso wola tuli azamanya. Era manje chijio kugu, iranga ekonomi, ekomi yo mikono ya. Kubanzi inga hamu, chikindu wacha nchini kubili mchuku mwadi. Awa nabayo kade zuba jazini, mpakuwa bazida kwa county yangi. Na ye, chiri kugwanga liya kitu Uganda. Banka zi mwuzi tutemitu ya na Uganda limeka. Bajaja wafi, batata wafi, baganda wafi, wameka wafi, ndwe mtu yao. Niba mitu wala nga banka zi mwuzi mitu wala. Atenga wajita mkoti zi mwuzi njini njini. Nemu na Uganda wafu deo na alopa umusango mkoti na asinga banka. Ulo wafu deo wagande, tila judgment is reckless, si chitufu, techisoboka. Bagayo mbulamba lamba batu gambe, ndikoti zaako le wawo wagwira. Era tuwali ba muna Uganda aliwangula banka mu courts of law. Net basing on principles, legal principles. Chine chitu no mwanu mutachi daba, tibada. Ama tubajja ko sente zanga ate mtu bakola biri iligo, sente za febajja zitu dizanga ba na Uganda, ate ne ba na Uganda abasigadde mu namu namba 10 omulanga mulekerawo kweti ate tuyimize gwanga lya Uganda, ngayo tugamba for God and my country to be strong, to be prepared against these acts. We are simply, actually, we are not simply underdeveloped. We are simply overexploited. Kwa nusuwa la gamba, wakena mtu kwa natuli wavu. Nitu suwa kuwele wavu, atembu wachi wajia wafu kumonyi zao uchi. Ogaga. Owali wavu, jano unonyi zao ogaga. Tituli wavu, ilate wakulimba. Now we are simply exploiters. Watuta chusa mumbele mtuibidangawa na Uganda. Eguanga tujali itilangu isi, nga watu soka. Katusabe katonda, atukwatide kutulabengu, utaru unu tuluguana fene wamu, ngaba na Uganda. Ye principal judge, mumusango kutuwala kwa na fetu njenda kukola apili. Neku enu oda jako zi. Neku fayo reje tutuwala na ye kwa hali. Court ya apili, ete kukula mandi principal judge ili akola, ya mikula mateka. Under legal proper procedures. Fayo jayita, ajita mutufu. Ya ino uizo huli na fayirenu. Ya ino uizo uisako oda angazi. Nukumu na mjire wa judge meruling jayi sisi ni completely, absolutely biased. So ni utusawe katonda atukua atiliko. Nenga checho kusawe nenga amba uu kakafu. Ntukukoto of appealing legitude intutina legal principles and zili strong. We shall stand. Ida tujia kuangu utaro.